Okay.
We gotta make flaps of skin.
Sounds nice.
Lovely. Donkeys and ponies and horses and dogs and, I don't know, probably us, have this connective, this little skin right here between their belly and their leg. And they need to be able to still move, which is why it's there in the first place. But when we build ours, we got to make sure that we don't lock it up and that they can still move. But it also kind of helps fill in this big dip right here. So it is, let's see, let's try to pull like 2 inch, kind of like the minimum that you can pull off of this solid piece of core. And then split that in half. So you have two little, like 1.5 inch wide sections. And then you want to put just a little bit going across the lower half. Just a little bit. Not the same amount or anything like that. And then you're going to stab across the center line and just make a taco. And what this piece going across does is give it some stability. If you didn't have any fiber going at 90 degrees the opposite direction, this could just pull apart. So this just gives it a little bit of stability. And then I'm going to use my punch tool. Am I on camera there?
What,
I might have moved something around.
This is my face
now.
So you want this nice rolled edge and then the fringy, everything else to be fringy. So just stretch the leg back a little bit so that it doesn't get locked up. And then you want to put it just a little higher than the bottom part of the belly. And it should attach to the upper leg and body. Like so. Mario says that.
Says like name. So?
Like so.
Mario who?
Batali. But the Italian chef guy.
Oh.
Can't remember his last name.
I was thinking Mario from Nintendo.
Marcia would know what Mario from Nintendo says. Aren't her kids super into that?
Yes.
My family never was. Okay. Done. Finito. We need nice little round donkey butt cheeks, and they are made on the Zoli tool, and you want to take about a 5-inch piece. Let's do this actually in gray. We'll do this in gray. Split it in half, and you're going to wrap a rectangle about 1.5 inches around the Zoli tool. And again, try to go out and back.
So you're making the butt pieces, eh?
Yes, we are making our ass. And then they give a little bit of, they're not quite as super round back here like the ponies. It's kind of, instead of making this into a big C back here, we want to give it some dimension on top. So kind of let the taper come down here and the top of it actually come around the top of the donkey on top of his back. So this is some stabbing because you're not wrapping anything. You're trying to stab a shape onto, make sure that tail stays up. That's what's cool about the Zoli tool is it makes a shape that's the right consistency to keep stabbing. It's not, when you make a shape on your felting surface, you're in danger of stabbing it too much that you can't felt it once it's on. Alrighty, nice little donkey butt. I'm trying to think if I put... Okay, I won't worry about that right now. We're going to make some shoulders, also using the Zulu tool. And let's use about a 5 or 6 inch piece of gray, split it in half lengthwise. Give it a little stretch. And then you're going to wrap the center of the tool. So it goes around the round part, up a facet, around the flat part, down one of the facets, and then you just kind of go around and pull the whole thing together. And then you have to slide it off this way. It won't go the other way. So around the round part, up, around the flat part, down, and then the rest of it kind of just around the whole thing.
You don't use that area very often.
I do for these shoulders. Yeah. Almost always this is a shoulder. So I have a wider flat part and then a thinner round part. And that goes right here. And this makes a nice shoulder. Like, this is great on the deer. We did it on the lions. It gives a little bit of muscle to this area and can create the withers or the shoulder blades as well. So I want to taper this end onto the upper leg, but not too, don't put too much there. And for now, I'm just gonna let this stick up, but I'm gonna shape that more in a minute. So tapered end just meets that upper leg. Careful, there's a lot of wire. I said wire better that time.
You just needed lunch.
I was making fun of myself for not being able to say my R's very well. A lot of wire in that shoulder. Okay, we need two pieces for the neck. We're gonna make two basically logs on the Zulu tool and put them on. That way it gives us this nice flat neck instead of the neck getting all round and tubular. Someone's here. Okay, we're gonna take a 6 inch piece of gray, split it in half lengthwise, and wrap the round part of the Zulu tool about the length of the neck, so it's about 2.5 inches. So I wanna go out, and I wanna be sure that I can go back. And keep it really consistent. Make that nice and smooth and slide it off. We gotta do that 2 times. Good. It's fine. They can bark all they want because I'm not talking. Okay. And then whichever one's bigger, I feel like this one's bigger, I'm gonna put it on the top. So stretch that neck out.
Milo, really?
Let this, let one end come down in between the withers here, and let the other end come to the top of the head.
Finley's a little noisy.
Oh, jeez.
Thanks.
And you can't stab this on too well. You just have to kind of angle it towards that wrapped wire and try to get an edge of it in. And then this other one is gonna go down here, and you want one part to meet the chest, and you want the other part to actually come up onto the head a little bit under the, between what will be the cheeks, because that's, on a horse, it's like their throat latch, but that's their juggler, is that what it's called?
Jugular?
Jugular. It's not their juggler.
Nick's the juggler.
Nick's the juggler. Stab that on. Now we have donkey neck. Oh, my donkey's not fat enough. He's a skinny little thing. Then we're going to take a nice sort of 3-inch piece of gray. Oh, wait, let me think. Never mind. Rewind. Rewind. Take a 6-inch piece of gray. We need to wrap. I was going to do a fold. We need to wrap. Split it in half lengthwise and stretch it out. See, once you stretch it out, now it's like a 10-inch piece. And then just real evenly, without letting these tip too far, wrap this neck. And stab it flat.
Hungarian proverb.
Okay, let's hope these guys say something that makes some sense.
If there is no horse, a donkey will do as well. Everyone's down on the horse.
What? Down on the donkey.
They're kind of all like that.
Jeez.
No respect. How about this one? A Haitian proverb. The donkey sweats so the horse can be decorated with lace. Told you it was deep.
All right, I like to put one more little shape in here, and that's just a soft pillow that kind of connects the shoulders to the neck and chest here. So with the oatmeal, take off about a 3-inch piece, split it in half, and just roll a little 1/2 inch or 3/4 inch rectangle. And then that just goes right in here, and just, it should be soft so that it can just blend at an angle, sort of at a 45, shoulder to neck to chest. So these shapes are meant to start to blend together, they're not like isolated little shapes. So I just roll it in my hands, fold it. Basically, I'm trying to make more of a rectangle than a tube, and let it fill this area. You could use gray there too. I just feel like the oatmeal, once you put the pelt on, it helps blend everything together. My donkey's too skinny. Okay, now I can felt the tops of these shoulder pieces together into his or her little withers. They don't have a real pronounced withers like ponies do. Well, ponies sometimes don't either. Fat little things. Where are we, Milo? We are...
You keep saying your donkey's
you know
not
what?
Fat enough.
See, I do this all the time. I needed to put the ears on.
Oh.
Yeah, because the ear wire should get down. Like, we should have put the ears on before we put the neck on. But it's okay. We're going to do it anyway. If you've pre-watched, you can...
People are going to get rewarded for watching first.
I know. But don't worry about it. This happens to me all the time. And you can get them down in there and still covered up. But basically, it's better to do the ears. And the reason I always forget about it is because I work on a piece at the same level from armature to finished details, the whole piece. And so, but this is an exception to that rule because you have to do the ears on the wire finished first. Before you finish anything else. So
you make an ear before you put it on?
You make the ears.
Huh.
And you put them on before you do all this stuff because it's got to get, that wire's got to get kind of like the reindeer antlers. Yeah. So, but it's okay. Well, I'm gonna show you how to do it.
All right.
So you ears, know, huh? Ears, yeah. All right. So what I'm gonna do is just back this up a little bit. Back her up. Boop, boop, boop. There we go. See, it's not that hard. Everything's still there. He looks like he's getting swallowed by something else. Okay, ears. This is really fun. So this is good. We're gonna take a break from our boring armature wrapping and make an ear. You have a 22 gauge wire in your supply pack. And what you want to do is find the center. The center, Sarah. Okay. And then out from the center, sort of like an eighth inch each way, you're gonna fold up. So it makes a tiny little W if you folded your center sharply. And then you wanna go 2 1/4 inches. So 1 2 1/4. And then sharply fold down. 1 2 1/4. Doop, doop. Okay. So now you have an M. Now the trick with this, there's two little tricks. One is pre-wrapping the wire so that you get these black tips are automatically there and your wool has something to grab onto when you fold it over. And the other trick is keeping this wide and not letting it close, because if you keep it wide, then you can pucker it at the bottom and get that deep, deep ear shape. So we're gonna take a little strip, remember the black core that we used for the feet and how we pulled off? We're gonna do that again. You're gonna pull off about 1/4 inch strip. Try to keep it from breaking. Split that in half. And then wrap up. You might have to open it up a little bit. One side. Skinny, skinny, and tight. You know how they say, like, you can't be, what is it, skinny or tan enough or something like that? There's some saying.
You can be too skinny and you can be
too
tan.
You can be too tan. I agree. I totally agree. Then we're going to do our little figure eight wrap here a couple of times. So I'm going to go back over to this side and then back over to this side. And then that gives us a little triangle of wool at the tip. And then you're going to come down the other side. Well, what I was gonna say is that in needle felting, they can't be, on certain things, little skinny legs, it can't be too skinny or too tight.
This is true.
Because you can always add more wool if you need to, and tight is good. Less needle felting, good. See how you just keep twisting that? You could put a little U-smooth on your fingers and do that, and it'll stay. Stay right there. I can flip this around since there's no front and back yet. So when you're working with such a skinny piece, you've got to work close to the wire, because if you hold it too far away, it's going to break on you. You can do, this is the way we do the hair ears. Who else has big ears?
Kangaroo.
We did not do wired ears on our kangaroo, but you could. Kangaroos are so interesting. They're like a deer meets a rabbit meets a, I don't even know what.
Did you say anteater?
Anteater. Once, what?
Well, there's a donkey fact.
Okay.
Not
oh,
really.
A fact. That's our
yes.
Good.
A donkey in the right conditions, like in the desert, a donkey is capable of hearing another donkey up to 60 miles away.
Wow.
Of those puppies.
Yeah,
right there.
And have you heard them bray?
Yes, they're loud.
It is crazy. Okay, the ears are 2-inch squares of gray. So you just pull off right from your roving a nice 2-inch square. Make sure it's consistent. And then I like to do a little dark gray at the tip. And then perhaps a little bit of the burrow bat that comes in your kit. It's a thin layer. That's it. You could put black at the tip, but I try to just let that black be it. So you're gonna flip that over. It's just easier to do one at a time. Line it up. Like I said, keep this nice and wide. So you can start by just stabbing this down and getting things under control. And then you're gonna fold the sides in and let them just overlap that whole surface. Pretty already, right? This is better than a cooking show. Really?
Yes.
Well, first of all, we work real time. Okay. And then you want your punch tool. Don't let it get embedded.
Calorie-free fiber.
Calorie-free. I'm actually burning calories right now.
Yes.
I could squat while I work. See that nice blend? So pretty. Okay, other one. What else? Why else is it better than a cooking show now that I said that? I should
back it
have
up.
More reasons.
You can walk away from your project and it won't spoil.
Oh my gosh, I've burned my granola so many times in the last two times I made it. This time I saved it just in time. The last time I really did burn it, but I ate it anyway, which was kind of grossing me out, but I couldn't throw it away, but I couldn't share it with anybody. I usually make it to share it, and so I had to eat it all. I think I did end up giving the end of it to my rat. He rejected it. Okay. So cute. Now, before we, like I said, we've got to finish these all the way. So, I like to give them a nice little white fluff on the inside of the ear, and then just a little white line on the outside of the ear. In your supply pack is some of our white. I included it in case you want to whiten up the off-white a little bit. Sometimes I just use the off-white straight. Sometimes I feel like it's a little too off-white. So for these finished details, I've been blending the two together. So I want to take a nice little section of it, restack it to make it as small as possible, and then basically on the insides of the ears do a fur treatment. So just a little wool staple going down, and then you're gonna fluff this out. And then I'll take a little bit and go down the outside of the ear. This is just a line. And if you want to, take some black or a little bit of the really dark gray. You can even mix them together. I'm gonna save half and put a little bit of darkness in the center. Go into the darkness. What's that song? Running from all the things there. Oh, it's a Jonathan Richman song, which is probably not on most people's radar. He was the guy in There's Something About Mary.
Oh.
The musician.
Yes.
Okay. So I just made that statement about working real time, and then I did my other ear off camera. Uh-huh. So you've done both your ears, all their little details, and now we want to pinch the bottom together. take a tiny strip of burrow. So just a little bit, like a little 2 or 3 inch piece that's real thin. And wrap around this pucker. Try to keep this ribbon-like, like spread out and ribbon-like so that it blends rather than like makes like a, what's the word I'm looking for? You want it to become one with the ear, not look like you tied a string around it. Oh, it's a lot of floof. So cool. So cool what wool does. Maybe our t-shirt could say, wool is cool. Instead of wool fool. Wool is
cool. You have to know what you're doing a little bit for it to do cool stuff.
It takes practice. Which is the fun part, really. You gotta enjoy the process. This is what we say to make people who don't know what they're doing yet feel better. No, it's true. Enjoy the process, because it is fun. Okay, so now I have these ears with a lot of wacky fluff that I'm going to thin down a little bit. Okay, what you want to do is get this at the top of the head, right at the tippy top. You can even put it on top of that neck bump. And then hold it in place and let these come under the throat here, real tight. But don't twist them or anything. Don't do them like a twist tie. They just cross in space under there. They just like two ships in the night. And then take the remaining wire and get it folded around the top of the neck. So I'm just coming behind the ears, folding it around until it doesn't exist anymore. So you don't want them to be too low. They've got to be up at that point. And then take a very thin, long piece of gray cord. So real thin, maybe about 6 inches long. And wrap in a figure eight. So I'm going to go between the ears, under the chin, around the back of the head, under the chin. This is the same as the chest wrap. Under the chin, and then back between the ears so that I made an X. And that's holding, covering all that ear wire and holding it down. And he looks totally crazy. Don't be alarmed. Probably could have used a slightly bigger piece of wool there. I caution against doing it again because you don't want it to get like crazy bulky. All right, so he looks nuts because he's got these like gigantic ears and no face yet. But trust me. Do you trust me?
Yes.
Trust you? It's gonna be great.
What you poking at there?
I'm just poking at my ass.
Sounds a little it's personal.
It's day two here. They don't know that, but it is. I can't live with this skinny donkey anymore, so I'm gonna fatten it up. And partly it needs a little pillow down here, and partly it needs a wrap. So I'm gonna take my off-white, piece of off-white, and Finley's going to town on a bone over there, and make a nice big loose pillow. Maybe your donkey's fatter than mine, but mine is too skinny. And just put that and let these fuzzy edges taper. And by making it loose, I can just shape it really easily rather than like rolling a firm shape. This I can just make blend. That's better. And that one maybe doesn't need a wrap. I'm not gonna do a wrap. That might have just done it. So I made Kyla watch Jonathan Richman videos this morning. After my vague reference yesterday, I couldn't get him out of my head.
People should YouTube Jonathan Richman.
He's really fun.